Buongiorno a tutti from Maestro Vito Jacopelli. Welcome back to my live Sunday live. Yes. Oh my God, today I feel powerful. Sì, ci siamo? Salta la pubblicità, via, così con... rispondiamo a tutti quanti. Today we're gonna answer, we're gonna try to answer to everyone. Please guys, go ahead and share the video right now. Just go ahead and send it to the people on WhatsApp or Facebook or whatever you want. Dai, condividiamo. Sweat a little bit. Some people come, at least 100, and we will start this amazing live video full of information free. Yes. Today, oggi andiamo, vi farò vedere un sacco di cose, sarà molto divertente perché l'ho scritto e vi farò aspetta, ecco qua, siamo 100, we can start. Okay guys, today we are going to talk about manage the dough. Of course, we are going to do the pizza roll. Everything is ready here. Got some dough, the ingredients, the oven ready. And then two ways how to cook the pizza roll, which is the air fryer. I don't know if somebody have an air fryer. And then, of course, in our oven, we have our stone warming up already for 1 hour ago. Voila. And then I'm going to show you today how to stretch the Neapolitan pizza, just the stretching part. Oggi vi dimostrerò anche come stendere la vera pizza napoletana e tutta cioè praticamente la tecnica fatta al momento. La cosa più importante è andremo a capire come usare l'impasto e come e quando usare l'impasto. Today I'm going to start with manage the dough. So let's go ahead and see. This is the dough. Take it off this one. So if you guys have any question after, you guys can. This is my perfect dough that I suggest to do home. Questo è l'impasto migliore da fare a casa o anche in pizzeria. È 70% di idratazione e 48 ore di fermentazione. Ok, parlo un attimino in inglese prima, così non ci confondiamo. Ok, guys, I'm going to explain this one in English first and then also in Italian because we have so many people in Italy that they don't speak English, so I have to translate it. In the meantime, we have 210 people. Please leave a like and share the video. Ragazzi, condividete su Facebook, così siamo in tanti e questo video diventa più divertente. Ok, yeah, let's get back to the... To the dough, I want to show to you. There we go. I want to show to you the dough, how it is, really quick. In the meantime, get the oven warming up. There we go. So, like you can see, the dough is strong and nicely. Okay, this dough is at the right point of fermentation. Okay, right point, that means that is in between. That means it's in between from overproofing and not proofing, not proof. So that means is the right point. Right point means that you can use the dough. So you have to use the dough when is at the correct point. That's number one. Number two is when you have overproofing dough, because I see so many people that tag me on Instagram that with the dough overproofing. So before you in the video I say 4-6 hours whatever, but in your room temperature can be too hot, so the dough will raise faster. What do you do in that point? You check the dough when it gets to this point, which is when there is no bubble, no extra bubble on top of the dough, when it's nice and smooth. At this point, the dough needs to go in the fridge. In the fridge, we are going to block the fermentation, and then you are going to save it. So let's say this one overproof now, but I'm not ready to make the pizzas. What I do, I go ahead, I I block it in the fridge. So in 1 hour, 2 hours tonight, I take out the dough 1 hour before. Simple. Now, if you have any question about this overproofing dough, please comment now. This way we will answer. 13 is if it's not overproofing, let's say it's too little. How do you know that it's not overproofing? Well, easy. The dough, you'll find the dough a little bit hard, not full of air. The dough needs to be full of air. So when you touch it, it needs to, you know, you're going to feel the air. It's not hard. So when it's small, you see it. And then also when you turn the ball, you see a lot of air inside. See? So if it doesn't have that, the dough is not ready. So what do you do? Well, if you need to make the pizza, this case, you have to go ahead and put it in the oven with a towel on top. You go ahead, you put the dough with a towel on top. You put it in the oven with the light on, oven off, light on. You put it in the oven and the dough will grow a little bit faster. Fantastic. Domande?
Vito.
So I'm gonna answer to some question in English and then I go in Italian really quick. Sì.
Vito, how grams is your dough?
This dough is 280 grams balls. I mean one little bit bigger because today for the pizza roll we need the dough a little bit bigger. Right. In the meantime, you know what? I'm gonna put some sausage on cooking. Okay, amici, allora. Metto un attimino la salsiccia a cuocere, un po' di olio. Là.
So stop dough from proofing in the refrigerator.
Yes.
To reach that proofing, take it about 2 hours before. That's right.
Yes.
Peter,
you have to put the dough in the fridge when it's at the point the fermentation is nice and proof, like this one, nice and smooth.
How come it comes bubble on my pizza balls?
Depends what kind of bubbles. I need to know if they are small or big, the bubbles. There we go. So now we are preparing the ingredients for our pizza roll. Stiamo preparando un po' i cottura lenta. Prepariamo un pochettino di i nostri ingredienti. Okay. Amici, I'm going to explain this one in Italian. You comment if you have any question. This way we will answer to you in the meantime. Ok, come fare quando abbiamo la pasta che è cresciuta troppo, quindi scoppiata in questo caso, tra virgolette. Un impasto che ha superato la sua crescita, quindi lo troverete pieno di aria, pieno di bolle, ed è ovviamente difficilissimo da usare e addirittura il cornicione non si gonfierà come deve. Quindi, come prevenire questa crescita, questo overproofing? Praticamente, l'impasto, il goal è farlo arrivare al nostro punto di crescita. Il punto di crescita è praticamente questo qui. Perfetto. Praticamente liscio, troverete l'impasto liscio senza queste bolle qui. Quando comincio a fare questo tipo di bolle, l'impasto sta praticamente sta passando il suo punto di crescita. Quindi, cosa si fa? Bisogna subito, se non fate le pizze a questo punto, prendete e bloccatele nel frigorifero. Quindi l'impasto si bloccherà e quando andremo a fare la pizza stasera, la usciamo un'oretta prima o mezz'oretta prima. Speriamo che ci siamo capiti qua. Ok, se l'impasto non cresce, se ci sono domande in inglese, dimmele che mi fermo. Se l'impasto non cresce, vuol dire che fa troppo freddo, oppure avete messo troppo sale nell'impasto, oppure troppo duro. Questo è un impasto del 70%, 48 ore di fermentazione. Quindi, se l'impasto non è cresciuto, mettete una tovaglia sopra l'impasto, lo mettete nel forno con la luce accesa, il forno spento.
Impasto diretto?
No, 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 non è un impasto diretto, questo qui è un impasto fatto con il polish. Il polish è un preimpasto prefermentato, liquido. Niente, quindi l'impasto deve essere usato a punto di crescita della pasta, che sarebbe questo qui. Ecco qui, troverete l'impasto. Ok, andiamo in inglese, se ci sono domande.
Sugar o no sugar on dough?
No, no sugar.
How much yeast are you using?
So we're using 5 grams of yeast. 5 grams of yeast. So guys, now we are cooking the sausage, our ingredients. So now it's time on, I'm going to show you how to stretch Neapolitan pizza proper way live. Amazing, thank you so much for the donation. Pelle, hi Vito. Hi Vito, are you ever going to show how to make pineapple pizza? Come on, man, no. You gross, white, my wife actually like it, fantastic. I was watching your video from Hawaii, so funny. Thank you so much, Pelle. Ok, so ora vi dimostrerò come stendere la pizza napoletana, quindi attenzione. Sì, ci sono domande? Ok, guys, I'm going to show you how to stretch the dough. Now is the right moment to put a like and subscribe, like and share this video. Condividete, amici. Ok, attenzione, come stendere la pizza e dopo passiamo ai nostri pizza roll. Eccoci qua. Ok, let's get this one. Anzi, quella più piccolina. Perché ho fatto una pallina un po' più grande per fare i nostri peccati del re. Sono in Napoli, si chiama. Ecco qua il nostro impasto, andiamo a stendere. Ok, the first thing to do is we have to put a little bit of flour on top. Then we get a spatula. The spatula needs to be the size of the bowl. If it's too big, you're going to have so much problems. Guys, this is very important for the people that don't know how to stretch the pizza. So we're going to go ahead, put a little bit of flour on the spatula, and we're going to put flour under the pizza. We want to take out the balls just how it is on the, we're going to put it in the flour. L'impasto deve essere tolto nella stessa maniera, non possiamo andare a incordarlo troppo. Quindi, piano piano, se vedete che l'impasto va dentro, allora mettete la più farina. Guys, if the dough goes under, go ahead and put a little bit of flour. Okay, now that we have put, detached, we go ahead and put it in the flour upside down. I want to show you the dough. Now let's close up the one that we don't use and put it on the side. This way we're going to make the pizza roll in a little bit. Cook it in two ways. Okay, like you can see, the dough, this is when the you notice that the pizza dough is ready, when it have a lot of air inside. So now gently get a little bit of flour, you put it on the counter, and then this dough, we're gonna go ahead and a couple of times, you need to be gentle. If you're not gentle, the dough will get nervous, and then it's gonna be hard, it's gonna go up. Give me 1 second, I'm gonna change the light bulb. Si è scaricata la batteria. Vabbè, facciamo a cambio, un secondo solo, incidenti di percorso. Incidenti di percorso, sorry for the light. Ok, let's go back here. Now, let's pick it up and let's put it on top the flour. So we want to make a little mountain here. C'è una piccola montagnetta, andiamo e adagiamola. Quindi, attenzione. So this is how you stretch the dough. Ecco come la stendiamo, la pizza napoletana a canotto. Giriamo qui la salita. Non bruciamo la cucina. Eccoci qua. There we go. So now, hopefully. Okay, you with your feet, use your finger, learn how to watch, how to look from your fingers. So, dovete misurare la pasta con le vostre mani, dovete praticamente guardare l'impasto tramite le vostre mani. Quindi, andiamo e pressiamo, dobbiamo solo pressare, no, non tirare l'impasto. So, guys, we have to just press, just like that. So you're going to feel all the air in the dough. So what we're going to do, we have to push the air to the crust, but we don't want to go too much, or the air is going to go ahead and we're going to go ahead and lose the air. Andiamo qui, ecco qui. A questo punto, quando abbiamo un centimetro, chiudiamo così, in questo modo. So guys, when you have 1 inch from the edge, you go ahead here and you block the dough just like that. Just a little bit, not too much. Now, you go ahead and flip the dough just like that. And you do the same thing. Press, 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 and pump. See the air? It wants to go out, but we don't want to make the air to go out. Now, one end, like that, and then you go ahead and flip it over. Mi attacchi il computer, c'è qua. C'è la... sta qua, qua. Ok. Perfetto. Ok, allora, abbiamo girato, e ora pressiamo un po' più forte. Guys, go ahead and press it a little bit more strong. Thank you so much for your donation. Philip, are you fermenting the dough in the refrigerator? No. When the dough gets to the point of the right fermentation, go ahead and you put it in the fridge to block the fermentation. Okay, amici. Now, let's go ahead and let's press a little bit more strong with your finger. If you see, I'm not stretching like this. I'm just pressing. Non sto stendendo in questa maniera, perché quando andate a fare questo movimento, la pasta si innervosisce e si incorda ancora di più. Dobbiamo soltanto pressare. One more time. And done. At this point, one end here, not to the crust, but inside. And then you flip it on top with your hand and you take off all the flour. Salsiccia. Quasi pronto. Okay, now the clap technique. You press with your right hand and you pull with your left hand. And then your right hand is gonna go like this when you flip it over. So go ahead and turn your hand and voila. And then down. Press and pull lightly. So I wanna show you to you something. Pay attention of this cut and see, I'm just straight. I'm not turning my hands, because when you're turning your hands, you're just gonna go ahead and make nervous the dough. So pay attention. I do one movement. One, two. One, two. Did you see? He's turning. He's turning by himself. Look, I'm just going straight. See? He's turning. Amici, state notando che la nostra pasta gira automaticamente. Quindi non andate a girare la vostra mano così, perché la fate soltanto innervosire la pasta e non si stenderà mai. Okay, guys, when you have 10 inches about your side, a little bit smaller than your side that you want, this is the third step. You go ahead, your hands, instead of put it like this, just like that, you put it on top. Then you go under with your hand, under the pizza, and then you make the pizza with your hands, just like this, not up. When you go up, you're gonna make a hole. So you go like this, and you make it large. And then you go ahead on the peel or on the counter, you go ahead and you put it down, just like that. Done. At this point, we don't touch it anymore, and the dough is nicely stretched. Now is the time to comment. Okay, amici nostri, il terzo step. Andate, mettete una mano al contrario qui sopra la pasta, la giriamo, la andiamo a mettere sulla nostra mano, con l'altra mano sinistra andiamo a mettere sotto, e con le mani in giù, non in su perché l'andate a bucare, andiamo a formare la pizza un po' più grande. Quindi la allarghiamo così, andiamo sulla nostra pala e la mettiamo sopra, senza toccarla più. Se avete domande, ecco qui come stendere la pizza napoletana. That's how you stretch the dough. Hope you like this video. With this one now, I'm not going to throw it away. I'm not going to make a pizza because it's not the case today. So I'm going to go ahead and flip it over like this, and then I'm going to take off all the air, and then I'm going to make the bread for later today. If you want to see how to make the bread, We can see that later. Okay, the sausage is ready. I'm gonna turn it off. Okay, andiamo a make the bread later on today. So I'm gonna put it like this, cover with the towel, and then easily we have the bread in 1 hour and a half. I'm gonna save it at room temperature. I'm gonna put it in the oven and cook it for the bread. Done. Let's go right here. There we go. Okay, we are ready for the pizza roll. Amici, siamo pronti per fare i nostri peccati terre o i cosiddetti pizza roll, il sushi. C'è tanta gente che li chiama. Salsiccia è pronta.
Sergio e Vito, ma ci sono delle cozze nel contenitore vicino a quello della salsa?
Le cozze? Ah, no, no, no. Sì, ora andiamo subito. Ok, guys, for this pizza roll, I'm going to use some purple potato. Andremo ad usare le patate viola cotte al forno con un po' di rosmarino e sale. Patata viola biologica. These are potato, purple potato, organic. You can see, amazing when you put it on the pizza. Amazing. We got some tomato sauce, not too much, just a little bit. Then we got fresh mozzarella and basil, and of course some pecorino romano. So now let's get into the actual pizza roll video. Please guys, leave a like and thumbs up. Lasciate un bel like. Okay, amici, stretching part we did it. Now let's go ahead, let's make the pizza roll. The pizza roll you need for this first one. For this first method, we're going to use a pan, or this one, or whatever you have. I have this one. And then we're going to cook in the classic way in the oven. Then the second method is going to be high fry. Amici, allora, non so se avete in Italia la friggitrice ad aria. Comunque oggi andremo a cuocere i nostri pizzaroni nel forno classici e nella nostra... e friggitrice elettrica
ad aria.
Ok, andiamo. So we're gonna go ahead and take it out. Non ci sono domande oggi? Un po'
no. Senti, pepper and onion,
yeah, you can put whatever you want in this pizza.
John,
you can put you guys can put whatever you want on this pizza, but the best for me is look at the dough. Wow.
Angelina, ciao from Wisconsin. I need to know this part. I make a mess with stretching my dough.
Okay. What's her name?
Angelina D'Amico.
Angelina, yes, thank you so much for becoming a member of my channel. I see that. And thank you so much for the support. So I see that. I see, and then I know your issue with stretching parts. So first, I believe you have the dough overproof, so it's becoming too hard to stretch. But I suggest to you to go back when we finish this video, to go back and check out how I did the stretching part and follow that at the letter, because it's only 3 steps. You're gonna be easy. If you still have any problems, just please comment and then I will answer to you. Okay, guys, these are the pizza roll. Bye. Oh, thank you so much for the donation. Dimmi cosa dice. Ok.
So, wish you could donate more. Thank you again, Vito, for your great video.
My friend, it's already a lot. Thank you so much. I really appreciate it for your support. So, guys, the pizza roll. We don't want to make any crust on this. We want to stretch just like that, just pressing. Amici, questa pizza, che sarebbe pizza roll, dobbiamo soltanto pressare in questa maniera con le dita. Non dobbiamo stenderla. Quindi è molto facile. Tipo la focaccia.
Vito, can you mail me one then?
No problem then. Okay, now, let's go ahead and just press. When we have the side of the pizza, same thing. We don't want any flour under. Otherwise, the flour is going to burn and it's going to hurt your body. It's not healthy for you. So we want to take off all the flour. from the bottom of the pizza. Voilà.
Mandami un saluto, Liliana dal Messico.
Ciao Liliana, come stai? Ciao a tutto il Messico. Done. Now that we press, we stretch, we're gonna go ahead and directly with ingredients. So at this, in this pizza roll, we're gonna go ahead and make it with purple potato, but you can put whatever you want. And we're gonna make sure that we put the ingredients everywhere. Everywhere, just like that. Done. Now we get our sausage. Really hot. Be careful, don't get burned.
English Rose ti ha fatto una donazione.
Oh, thank you so much, English. English Rose. Ok, per non bruciarci, andiamo a... Dove sta la... La forbice. La forbice, vabbè. Let's get our sausage. And don't worry about, because if it's sticky, this is going to be easy to fix. Ovviamente, ragazzi, non usate la salsiccia troppo bollente, se no è un casino. Guys, let's go ahead and let's cut the sausage in this way. But you know what? I prefer the sausage to break like that. The only thing that is way too hot. Let's let it cool down first, because it's too hot.
What kind of flour do you use?
I use 00 flour. Okay, there we go.
What's this recipe called in Italian?
The name in Italian of the pizza roll, the actual name, this is typical in Naples, is Peccati del Re. Che lo puoi scrivere, riesci a scrivere sotto. Peccati del Re. So this is a recipe that I learned about 16 years ago from my friend in Naples. His name is Salvatore Magno, one of the best pizza maker in Italy. Okay, guys, now we will put the fresh mozzarella. Now let's go ahead and let's put the sausage. I like to put the sausage broke on the pizza. This way, the taste is a little different. I don't know if you'll see.
Vito, hear you're working on links so we can buy all the products you use and recommend. Is that true, Vincent?
Vincent, yes, we are working on the, this is very important. Thank you so much, Vincent, for reminding me. Yes, we are working on some links with my team, which Vincent here is at again, the light. It's okay, the light went off the battery. I don't know what's going on, this light. Yeah, we're working on this links where you can buy anything that I using on the video. So, sausage shot. Let's go. Non va? L'hai messa? Aspetta, vediamo un po' la luce. So sorry guys, one second. Va bene, dai, lascia stare, le mezze a caricare però. Okay, we got the sausage, we got the potato. Let's get back to the video. So sorry for the light. Okay, now, or a little bit of sea salt. Actually, this is not sea salt, pink salt. A little bit, not too much.
Voilà. What's different of impasto in diretto and indiretto?
Well, that's a big question. Direct dough means that you make the dough simple and then you use it at night. And the indirect one means that you do a pre-fermented yeast, basically. Or you do the yeast the day before. Hopefully, that's a good question. Okay, now let's put some Parmesan on top. Done with our pizza roll. And then, actually, you know what? I'm going to put some rosemary inside. And just a little bit of basil. Not too much, just to give the flavor. And done, amici, abbiamo la nostra i nostri peccati del re. Now, that's the most funny thing here, the most important part of this amazing pizza rolls. We gotta If you want to add some tomato sauce, you go ahead and put the tomato sauce. But I'm gonna do another one in a little bit, simply cheese pizza. Okay, guys, now pay attention, attenzione ai nostri pizza roll. Andiamo e pieghiamo in questa maniera. Voilà. Ora li pieghiamo. Questa punta qui la addrizziamo. Let's go ahead and make it straight. And then, voilà, we have like a big, huge Italian burrito. Let's flip it over. We want to close really good the sides here. Now, a little bit of flour, not too much. Let's flip it over again. Very important. Now, at this point, let's tie the pizza a little bit close. And now we're going to go ahead and cut with a spatula. You can cut it just like that. Or you go ahead and get a knife, but it's not really healthy for your marble. I'm gonna do it just one time. Make sure you do this slowly, not too hard, otherwise you don't wanna make it too open. Now let's go ahead, let's make it. Let's put it on one side. What I like to do is to put a little bit of olive oil on our pan. Not too much. Well, I got too much. Then get a napkin, and then you go ahead and do it all over the pan, just like that. Just so you're making the focaccia. But you know, guys, you don't need to have something like this. You can also have something different, glass, whatever. Now let's go ahead and let's put, every time that we cut it, just like this. We're gonna put it far away each other. Make sure that you compress our pizza. Otherwise, you're gonna make a mess. Gently, go ahead and put it right there. Nicely done. Wow. Ci sono domande? This is like an Italian.
Lizzy, hey Vito, love your video.
Thank you.
Can you bake pizza without a baking stone? My oven only reached 230 degrees Celsius. Do you recommend buying a pizza stone still? Thank you.
No, I don't recommend a pizza still. Give me one second. Let's put this one and cook, and then I'm going to answer to all your questions. Let's remember this question, please. Let's get some olive oil, un po' d'olio, un pennellino. Ragazzi, questa è una ricetta tipica napoletana che mi ha insegnato il mio grande maestro 16 anni fa, Salvatore Magno. Ecco qua. Let's brush it. Let's brush the top. Let's brush the top. Done. And done. Now again, a little bit of sea salt, or the pink salt. Voila. Let's put a little bit of Parmesan cheese on top. And don't worry about if it goes on the pan, it's gonna burn. So don't worry. Done. Now, very important, the part of the Parmesan cheese, because the Parmesan cheese is going to become nice and crunchy. Now we're gonna put a little bit of oregano on top. Voila! Guys, our pizza roll are ready to go in the oven at the max temperature. There we go. So let's preheat the oven at the max temperature. Che succede? Falla venire, falla scendere, dai. Let's preheat the oven at the max temperature, and then let's go ahead and let's put the pizza roll on top at the max temperature. Right now it's a 400. I'm gonna go ahead and put a 500, but the oven has been on, is once preheat a little bit before. Now, in the meantime, I'm gonna answer your question. I'm gonna make another one to cook in the high fryer. This is a very nice equipment to have in your apartment. Okay, andiamo, facciamola. Let's answer to all of your questions.
So lui sì. Scrive: Can you bake pizza without a baking stone?
Well, you can. You can put it in the sheet pan, upside down, and then you can go ahead and cook it there. Vabbè, la luce vai viene. So sorry, guys, for the light.
Do you normally put the dough on semolina flour to stretch whole?
Yeah, I do. But today I finish my semolina and then I can't go out to buy more. So I'm gonna cut some cheese.
Is the uni oven worth it?
Yeah, why not? For a beginner, yes.
Maestro, how to make mozzarella in home?
Check out my video. Now it's really up.
Vito, can you bring our kids at the end?
Yes, of course. I'm gonna bring her. Thank you for asking. Now let's go ahead. Let's make one more. In the meantime, my other pecadillere are cooking. How you guys can see me without light? You see me good?
Where the potatoes cooked, Tony?
Oh, they are cooking the oven. Thank you, Tony, for asking. I put it in this one. Little bit of olive oil, a little bit of rosemary and put it in the oven. I cotto le mie patate al forno, amici, così in una pentola, un piatto di vetro. Andiamo, and now we're gonna go ahead and do the same thing.
I'm from India. Here temperature is very hot, around 37 to 40 Celsius. So what time of fermentation need the dough?
Okay, that's a really good question. Lo dico anche in italiano, questo perché è molto importante. Guys, that's a really good question. When it's really hot in your town, to slow down the fermentation, you need to put a little bit extra salt, less fermentation, that means less water, to make the dough a little bit more hard, and voilà, you slow down the fermentation. Quindi quando vogliamo rallentare la nostra crescita dell'impasto, è facile, se cioè, praticamente è estate, fa caldo, non abbiamo un frigorifero, mettiamo un po' più di sale, cioè mettete 25 grammi, mettiamo 5 grammi in più, 30 grammi o 35 grammi, e mettiamo un po' meno di acqua fredda, e quello automaticamente rallenterà la vostra crescita. Cioè, alto livello. Quindi, now let's go ahead, let's make another one, which I'm going to cook this one in the air fryer. Pay attention, guys, because in a little bit we're going to go ahead and flip it over our pizza rolls. Take off the flour again, stick it off the flour. This one we're going to make a classic cheese one because, my wife, she wants a margherita one. So we're going to make tomato sauce.
John, how many minutes do we leave at the highest oven?
About 6 minutes for the first time. Then we're going to take it out and we're going to go ahead and pre-cook it.
Maestro Vito, my whole family is watching you now.
Fantastic.
You are the best. Greatest thank you. From Chile.
Chi?
Una donazione.
Oh, thank you so much, Felipe. You are the best. Thank you. I really appreciate your support. So this one, mozzarella, this one, basically we're going to make a classic margherita pizza. Parmigiano, vuoi? Sì, un poco. Pecorino? No, non lo vuoi, ok. She doesn't like pecorino. Let's get the dark cheese. Let's break it apart. We want to put the mozzarella, the old ingredients everywhere. Guys, this is the method on the cooking in the air fryer. You also, after we finish this live here, I'm gonna set up the link under the descriptions. Wow.
You have helped me to find the joy of making food once again. For that, I thank you from the bottom of my heart.
Wow, that's a really nice message.
Una donazione.
Oh, come si chiama? Slap. Thank you so much. I really appreciate it. I really appreciate your message. Is amazing. Thank you.
Hey Vito, can we freeze the extra pizza dough?
Of course. Yes. We get there again. So we have mozzarella, tomato, basil, and oregano. Pay attention. We're gonna make it like a square. Facciamo un quadrato, eccolo qua. Andiamo e pieghiamo la prima parte e poi andiamo a fare praticamente un roulet. Voilà. Dimmi. Scan again.
Riesci a fare un video dove spieghi come fare il lievito madre?
Sì, ci sto provando, ho registrato un sacco, ma è un casino della Madonna.
Do the semolina helps to avoid the dough to stitch on the shell?
Semolina is better than flour. Today I finished it, so I didn't have the opportunity. So guys, pay attention to this. Now we have our pizza. Now let's get with two ends and we close it a little bit. Just like that. Done. We make a little burrito with the spatula again. Go ahead and cut the sides. Cut the sides. We want to keep it straight. Done. You might gonna make it closer a little bit. Touch it the less is possible. Then let's close it. Let's try to close the sides. Now let's go ahead. This is my first time. This is my first time ever cooking the pizza. Cooking the pizza in the air fryer. So we're gonna go ahead and try to make it. This one, I don't put any oil right now. Put it inside. Voila. Want to show it to you. Done.
Is enough to put 1 gram of fresh yeast in amount of 1 kilogram of flour and use dough in the same day?
1 gram, no, it's way too low. If you're gonna use it on the same day, it's way too low. I'm gonna put this one on cook, I'm gonna suggest you something. Let's put a little bit of oil, mettiamo un po' d'olio con il nostro pennellino sopra ai nostri peccati del re. Nostri roll, there we go, we'll put a little bit of olive oil. Done. Man, this makes the pizza a little bit more like a fry. So now let's go ahead, let's put some oregano. Same thing. Voila. Let's put some Parmesan cheese on top, but she doesn't like it too much, so we're gonna put just a little bit, just for the touch. And then a little bit of salt. I don't know if I put it already.
El lievito secco, se puede mescolar con la sala all'inizio, saludos con Barcelona.
One second.
Si può mescolare il lievito secco con il sale all'inizio?
Sì, perché no? Ok, guys, now let's go ahead. Scusate, ma sto cassetto. Via qui. Opla. There we go. Now, let's go ahead and expose it. Voilà.
Dear Vito, no matter how much flour I add to the dough, it's always sticky.
So now we, hold on. We put this one at... Okay, now we're gonna set it up at... Like he's cooking the chicken. So we have 360 Fahrenheit at 25 minutes. Halfway, scusate, okay, halfway done, we're gonna go ahead and flip it over. So now our pizza, the one in the oven, are about to go ahead, and we're gonna go ahead and flip it over. Yes. Wow. Gonna go ahead and we're gonna flip it over just like that. Use the same thing. You can try to save all the cheese there. There we go. We're gonna flip it over, guys. Pay attention. Very simple to make, don't be scared. Se avete un po' di mozzarella non fa niente, buttatela sopra. Voilà. Now, same thing. Careful, salt, a little bit of salt. Little bit of olive oil on top with a little brush.
How much you need to put yeast in amount of 1 kilo of flour to use in the same day, but in pizzeria, not at home?
Well, we get there in a little bit. Let me put this one on cooking because this is a very good question, so I would like to answer properly. Because I have a suggestion to you. I never use a direct dough because it's not the best. A little bit of oregano and a little bit of Parmesan cheese on top. Voila. Now let's go back one more time in the oven and we're gonna finish to cook for about another 10 minutes. Some of it under. There we go. Oops, cos'è caduto? Wash my hands. Ok, allora. Veniamo a noi, ragazzi. Veniamo a noi. There you go. Hey, Frank, thank you so much for your donation. Javito, thank you for showing us all your tricks. I make a pizza from a whole family and everyone loves it. Please don't stop being what you are, keeping going on YouTube. Yes, that's what I'm gonna do. I decide to do, basically. Thank you so much for your donation, my friend. I really appreciate it. Okay, guys, let's get back to the question of before about
How much I need to put this in amount of 1 kilo of flour to use in the same day, but in pizzeria, not at home.
Yes, yes. Remember one thing. Make the yeast the day before. This way, your dough, when you use it the same day, is still very, very digestible. Because if you make the dough in the morning, you use it at night or 6 hours after, the dough will be really heavy for you. Because it's keeping the fermenting. So it's gonna start to ferment in your stomach and you feel full. So make sure you prepare your yeast. You wanna put 1 gram, that's fine. Do the polish technique. You put 100 grams of water, 100 grams of flour, and 1 gram of yeast. You mix it up everything. Actually, you can put also 5 grams, it's not a big deal. You mix it up and you put it in the fridge for overnight. In the morning, you use that as a yeast. So you make your home recipe, simple, the same, don't change anything. You add this little pre-fermented dough in your dough. So, and done, you have the perfect fermentation.
Vito, I made polish last night and I'm going to use now, but it smells and liquid. It's still okay to use?
Yes. Yes, if you put it in the fridge, yes, it's still okay. Actually, even if you didn't put it in the fridge, let's check our Wow, this actually cook a little bit faster. Less than I think it was 5 minutes.
25.
Let's go ahead and let's know the first cook. Oh, they're gonna stay a little bit more. You can see a little bit more. It's still. Sorry, guys, but this is my first time using the high fryer for this type of things. I usually cook my chicken. I cook my steak. Sausage is there. Let's go ahead. Let's check out our pizza roll. There we go. Now, one more time. Those are almost ready. Nice. Whew. We want to do a couple of times because we want it nice and crispy. So now let's go ahead and let's try to put the part of the cheese under. That's it. Nice. Well, you don't even imagine the smell of this. I can't wait to eat it. Put it stand up. Voila, voila, and voila. Let's go back in the oven. Now, one more time. Se cadono, non vi preoccupate, mettete uno accanto all'altro. Cercate di non farli cadere. Done. Woo! Can't wait to show it to you. Let me try to put the light again. Non capisco perché si scarica così veloce sta. Okay, I'm back. I'm back. Now is the time to leave a like right there. Right there. Dai,
questa rolla.
Sì.
Questa rolla, Rono. Si può fare intera e poi dividerla. Ciao,
no,
da Torino e complimenti da un amico della vera cipizza.
Grazie, ti ringrazio tantissimo.
Rollatina.
No, perché Tina?
No, questa rollatina.
Sì. No, non te lo consiglio perché è proprio quello che fa, fa questi roll, cioè che, come li faccio io, li fa belli così, diventano un po' croccanti ai lati e un po' più, più saporiti, perché la mozzarella cade, esce fuori e quella mozzarella diventa dura e praticamente non so come spiegarlo, praticamente il sapore diventa più forte e è totalmente differente il texture che dà alla fine. Cioè, ora ti faccio vedere. Ok, Vito, sei il numero uno. Dove hai la pizzeria? A Melrose Avenue. Cioè, praticamente non ce l'ho più, l'ho data in gestione. Ok, vediamo i nostri pizza roll. Sì, non male, non male. Questi sono con la mozzarella e pomodoro. Semplici. Andiamo a girarli. Wow. Wow. Andiamo, giriamo. Un po' più complicato qui dentro, eh. Giriamo sul loro posto stesso. Let's go ahead and let's flip it over. Now a little bit of olive oil on top. Again. I don't know if you can see. Puoi dare una mano, eh? Ci sono domande qua. A little bit of...
una donazione.
Fantastico.
Is that amount of this fresh or dry yeast? Is it to get fresh yeast here in Norway?
No, you can use dry yeast. It doesn't make any, it's not a big difference of, you know, it doesn't make a big bunch of difference. You can check out my other video, the difference between fresh yeast and dry yeast dough. So it doesn't make a bunch of difference. Ma qual era la domanda? Is there amount of yeast fresh or dry yeast? Oh, you can use a dry, I suggest to you to use a dry yeast. So let's look for about another couple of minutes. Yeah, use a dry yeast because it's better when you do the pre-fermented dough. Or instant yeast, whatever. Or instant or dry yeast, I think it's the same thing. Now.
Would you like to make a video about fried pizza?
It's coming. Tuesday. Panzerotti Baresi. Fatti come si fanno alto livello. Thank you so much for the donation. Looks good. Windows Vista Professional. Thank you. Chi è questo Vista? Windows Vista. Windows.
Looks cool.
Fantastic. Forse Windows è proprio Windows.
Focaccia Technique.
Focaccia Technique. No, no. This is... what do you mean, Focaccia Technique? Okay. They are cooking. They're fantastic. Now let's go ahead and let's flip it over one more time. I will explain to you later on why I'm flipping it over a couple of more times. A couple of times, actually. Amo, guarda, falla venire qua. Voilà. Here we go. Nice. La puoi prendere, per piacere? Prendi, portala qua, facciamo vedere. E qua, there we go. Like, you can see this crispiness. Quello è perché dicevo, non l'aprite, non l'aprite. Ecco qua. Diamo un'altra volta nel forno e i nostri pizza roll saranno pronti tra poco. L'ultima volta. Voilà. Done. In the oven. Almost ready. Ico, va bene. Salutiamo i nostri amici. Opla, there we go. There we go, my baby. Say hi. E ciao. E ciao. Bacino volante. Ciao. Cinavante. Ok, guys, here we go. Con la pizza oggi. La pizza. Facciamo la pizza. She's ready to eat some pizza, guys. Con la pizza. Ok, avrei la pernacchia, infatti. Con la pizza. Ok, guys, let's check it out. Our the one in the front. Those are ready to go ahead and we're gonna flip it over. There we go. Now let's flip this one shot. I don't really like to make the simple one with the fresh mozzarella and tomato because, for this type of recipe here, you need to have some ingredients inside because tomato and mozzarella, then not. But you know, my wife wants the simple cheese one, so we got a simple cheese one. There we go. Voila. Hey, Kevin, thank you so much for your donation. Really appreciate it. Di ciao, di grazie. Andi bacino avanti. Hey, la linguaccia. Ok, vediamo, guarda la pizza, mamma, guarda. Che cosa c'è là dentro? La pizza. Ok, guys, I think they are done.
Have you ever used sourdough for pizza?
Sourdough for pizza? Yes, I did. Ok, guys, pay attention now. I want to see thumbs up only if you dislike. Only if you like it. Ok? Pay attention.
Can I do that in the uni oven?
Which one? Sourdough?
No.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, you can. You can. But be careful. Put a cover on top, a lid, because it's going to make a mess of olive oil. Ecco qua. Attenzione, papà. Woo! Done! Now, pay attention to this. I'm going to go ahead and put it on the plate. Usually, I put a little bit of arugula or salad, and then I put those on top. The smell, it's outstanding! Torniamo a noi! Si sogna tra poco. Eccoci qua. Square. Spune che si. Fai some green here. Non have any green. It's okay. We're gonna put some basil. We're gonna do the nice plate. Gonna make a plate, guys, for you, just for you today. Happy Sunday to everyone.
Today I made bigadoh pizza by hand, and it worked perfectly.
Perfect.
I was so
I'm so happy. Zlapan, that's the second donation. Thank you so much. I really appreciate it, my friend. Today I made bigadoh sweetly after finished the dough. Fantastic, Mario Compresso. Grazie tantissimo. Ci presto, grazie tantissimo per la tua donazione. Qual è la domanda? Che dice?
Ciao Vito, thank you for your videos. I miei genitori sono di Bari, ma abitiamo a Los Angeles. Oh. We have visited Prova and met you there on one time. Ieri abbiamo fatto la tua ricetta per panzerotti baresi.
Fantastico, fantastico. Panzerotti baresi, sto facendo la nuova ricetta martedì. Ecco qua, amici miei, ecco qua i nostri... Cioè, guardate, non si può mettere la luce in questo momento. Guardate la... mi faccio vedere un attimino la perché li ho fatti aperti. Eccoci qua. Look at this. Look at the crunchiest. Wow. Now, let's go ahead.
Hi Vito, what is better, cold fermentation or ambiente? Thank you a lot.
Cold fermentation, ambiente, always ambiente.
Vito, your food is amazing.
Thank you.
Donazione da English Law.
Wow, fantastic, grazie per le donazioni. Thank you. This one I'm gonna serve, I'm gonna eat it. And this is for the plate.
Hi Vito, where can I get that pan? I use it to make pan
well, pizza? That's I got that from Italy. Really hard to find it. Now we're gonna put just a little cherry tomato just for the look, you know. you don't have to put this. You don't have to do it.
Ciao Vito, ti volevo ringraziare. Da quando ti guardo ho imparato tantissimo. Mi piace molto come spieghi. Un saluto dalla Germania. Spero che leggi questo messaggio. Un saluto Gaetano.
Gaetano, io leggo tutti i messaggi. Tutti. Dalla A alla Z. Anche se prendo più di 100.000 messaggi ogni 6 mesi. Li leggo tutti. Guys, I read all the messages. And then if I can, if I have time, I reply to all of you. Guys, we are 600 people here. I see only 290 likes. That means that you don't like? Show me some love. There we go. Those are the pizza roll by Maestro Vito Iacopelli. Let me put some light. In the meantime, put a light right there. Vieni qua. There we go. It's amazing. So now, check this. Almost ready. Now, these are the pizza roll by Maestro Iacopelli. Like you can see, the cheese melted and made a little bit too crunchiest. Wow. These are amazing. They're a little bit hot. Let me cool it down a little bit. If you have any question, che dicono? Bello Ito, sono l'italiano che cercavi. Ciao, viva la pizza. Grazie. Simo Figo. Assaggiamo. Outstanding, the chicken with the sausage. The chicken with the sausage, the potato with the sausage, those purple potatoes are really, really good. But, I mean, take a look, guys. Amazing.
Can the fish be too cold to ferment the polish?
Aspetta, sto godendo un attimo, sto facendo l'amore con il sapore. Qual era la domanda? Ci riprendiamo, scendiamo a terra.
Can the fish be too cold to ferment polish?
It might be. So what you do, you leave it 1 hour outside the room temperature and then you put it in the fridge. And voila.
Vito, one question. If you make the dough and you have to let it rest for 3 days, those 3 days are the room temperature?
No. Max, you're going to go 1 day outside. Assaggiamo la pizza, com'è? Yeah. Sta per assaggiare. Vediamo cosa ne pensa. Cosa ne pensi? Com'è? Pappa. Dalla sua faccia possiamo dire che è fantastica ed è buona. Ok, torniamo a noi. God, my God. Ci sono parole.
Steve.
Soltanto 300 like.
Steve, vai. Hi Vito, from Athene. Can you one day see step by step how to make Mother East?
Yes, I'm trying to make this video from a long time, but it's really hard. It's really hard to put it together, to make it understandable, because my goal to this channel is to make the things really, really easy and understandable. Amici, io nel nostro canale, nel mio canale, troverete, cioè, il mio goal è per fare le ricette più facili possibili nel miglior semplice modo possibile, perché non vi posso dire l'idratazione, la fermentazione, tutti questi termini qua. Cioè, dobbiamo essere un po' più a casa. Cioè, una signora dice, ma che cos'è l'idratazione? Cioè, non so se mi spiego. Spacco proprio salute. Vabbè, forget about the light. I'm gonna throw it away. Ok, the pizza roll and dry fryer are ready.
Vito, can I make 75% dough with normal flour, strong flour?
Not as loud as strong. Yes, you can. You can. Let's put it. I want to show it to you. There we go. Let's put the one on the side, and now let's get the one cooking in the high fryer. I have to say they come out really good. I have to say. Now, let's get a plate. Voilà. Nice and crunchy. There we go. Yeah, not bad, not bad. I have to say. You go ahead and put a little bit of arugula on the bottom. Potete mettere un po' di arugula, un po' di per farli un po', per farli vedere un po' meglio, va, diciamo. Nice. Cotti nella air fryer. Wow, fantastic. Voilà. Togliamola di mezzo. Facilissima da pulire. And voilà. Pizza roll in the air fryer ready. Guys, cioè, l'ho cotti come si dice in italiano? La friggitrice ad aria. Spegniamo qui. Spegniamo il forno. Qua non sto andando a troppo caldo. Guys, there we go. Let's put it inside. Together. Inside. Voilà, voilà, voilà. E quando li fate nel forno a legna questi qua? Una cosa pazzesca. Pazzesca. Però così sono venuti pazzescamente, pazzescamente, pazzeschi. There we go, guys. There we go. We got the high fry and we got the oven. C'è un po' di luce, non si vede niente. C'è. Ecco qua. Ora andiamo e questo è il momento giusto dell'assaggio. Wow. Oh my God. Il test ci deve stare. Questo vabbè l'ho assaggiato già, mettiamo da un lato, assaggiamo questo qua. Wow. This one and the air fryer, I can't tell that it cooked too much the cheese, so it melted too much. But let's go ahead and let's taste it. Outstanding. But I have to say, those pizza rolls, they are better when you put the ingredients inside and not just the basic one margherita. So put whatever you like inside. Amazing. But I like more the one cooking in the oven. Just because the sausage, I mean, they're soft, look.
Ciao Vito, mi consigli una buona impastatrice su Amazon? La kitchenette a €700, una più economica?
€700, te l'ho detto, ce la dobbiamo portare dall'America in Italia. Qua in America la vendono $250. Però, cosa gli possiamo consigliare? Impastatrice che non sia kitchenette in Italia?
Una buona impastatrice.
Il KitchenAid è molto buono, però ovviamente costa troppo. E ci dovrebbero essere quelle impastatrici dove... no, sinceramente non... Impastatrici buone. Ci dovrebbe essere uno che assomiglia alla KitchenAid su Amazon, però costa la metà. Però sinceramente non ti so dire com'è. Wow, fantastic, guys. Amazing. Please, guys, try this at home because they are easy to make, simple. You make a little bit of mess to make this, but they are worth it to make. Amici, grazie tante per la visualizzazione, grazie tante per essere con me. Buonissima domenica. E se avete domande, se la compro sul sito KitchenAid, arrivi in Italia? Perché quelle che hai tu è top quality. Penso, non lo so.
Bisognerebbe vedere i costi di
spedizione. Non lo so, sinceramente, come si chiama? Fedrilli. Sinceramente io me la sto portando nella valigia, per dirtela chiara, perché ne ho due qui, allora me la porto una là e faccio anche la uso lì. Guys, those are the pizza roll. I'm gonna do the open part of the cheese. They come out good also in the air fryer, but of course I prefer the one in the oven regularly. Okay, guys, nothing. I want to say thank you so much for all the people today. They really donated to me. I really appreciate it. Thank you so much. I really thank you to everybody that's been here. I hope that everyone got their tip and nothing. Tuesday, I'll post a new video. Tuesday, I'll post a new video and... choose the new video about panzerotti fritti. And nothing, I'm gonna clean up everything here. Thank you so much for watching. Please, guys, keep supporting me. Thank you. Just by leaving a like and a comment below on the messages. And that's supporting my channel. And then if you want, you can become a member of my channel, which is in one month, I'll be doing a live streaming just for the people from members who join my channel. They really, really support me a lot. But thank you so much, Frank. Guys, amici, vi ringrazio tantissimi uno ad uno. Siete tantissimi. Spero che vi sia piaciuto questo video. Le pizza roll sono semplici, facili da fare. Io vado martedì, nuovo video con i panzerotti baresi. Applause, a big hug to everybody. Vuoi salutare papà? Vieni qua. Oh, oh, opla. Ciao a tutti amici. Coming soon. Our channel. Coming soon. Mi vedrete in un altro panni. Guys, pomodoro? Sì. Thank you so much, guys. Please comment and like the video. Keep in touch. Thank you. Happy Sunday to everybody. Ciao. Ciao papà.